What are the top 5 main reasons why your opportunity card visa can get rejected? I'm reviewing the rejection letters directly from the embassy. I'm collecting all that information and then I'm providing and creating these detailed videos for you. The English language or your German language skills are not good enough. Now, very surprisingly, this is a very different rejection reason I have seen this time. Hi everybody, welcome to my channel Good Peace in Germany, and today's video is super important for you in case if you're looking to apply for opportunity card visa for Germany. So in this video we are going to discuss what are the top 5 main reasons why your opportunity card visa can get rejected. Trust me, I'm talking to a lot of people and the visa rejection rate for opportunity card is super high comparatively to the job seeker visa, and the main reason behind that is that there are many people applying for this visa and they want to only issue the visa who has perfect documentation and do not want to take any risk, because the visa is given for 1 year, and that's why the German embassy has to be super sure that they are issuing the visa only to people who have everything mentioned correctly. So in this video we are going to discuss what are the top 5 main reasons why your visa can get rejected, and I have consolidated these reasons after reviewing lot of rejection letters that people have received, and then they have contacted me and we have discussed about these reasons for rejections. So all these reasons are actual reasons that are given by the German embassy in the rejection letters, and also I'm also going to provide you the solution. So this is the reason for the rejection, but what is the solution to solve that? So this video is going to be super important for you in case if you want to apply for opportunity card visa for Germany or you're already in the process. And trust me, every reason is super important. So please watch this video until the end. So without further ado, let's get started. But before that, let me tell you about myself. I am Gurpreet. I work in Germany as a lead HR since last 2 years, and I came to Germany on a job seeker visa as well. So I have started this channel to help you get your dream job in Germany soon. I provide a lot of content based on the immigration laws, the visa process, and also how do you find your dream job here in Germany. I'm a recruiter myself. I've already hired more than 100 candidates in Germany and all across Europe. So I explain you the end-to-end recruitment process regarding the European region. So in case if you have not subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and do that right now. And also please share this video with your friends and family who are also looking to move to Germany or any European country. So before we get into the video, I have a request. Trust me, the information that I'm providing you is very, very brand new information and nobody has this information. I'm reviewing the rejection letters directly from the embassy. I'm collecting all that information and then I'm providing and creating these detailed videos for you. The only request I have is click on that like, because my target for this video is to reach 500 likes so that I keep getting motivated to create more such videos and bring all this valuable information to you. So go ahead and click on that like button right now. So now let's get started with the video and understand what are the top 5 main reasons why your opportunity card visa can get rejected. So the very first reason why your visa can get rejected is because you are not showing enough money in your block account. So a lot of you decided that instead of using the block account, we will use our savings account or our FDs and store the proof of funds. But what I have heard is people who are showing the savings account, their visa processing is taken much more longer. There's a lot of scrutiny that has been performed on the visa applications that are showing the savings account compared to the visa applications that are showing the block account. And one of the main reasons that is mentioned in the rejection letter is that they need you to have around 12 lakh rupees, say approximately for the entire year. But in case if you transfer this money to your savings account just 1 week or even 1 month or 2 months before the visa application process, then it is clearly mentioned in the rejection letter that you have arranged these funds only for the visa processing and they are not sure whether these funds will be with you during your stay in Germany. So that is one of the major reasons why your your visa is getting rejected because you do not have enough proof of funds, or you're showing your savings account or your FDs and all that money has been transferred just few months before your visa appointment date. So definitely avoid that mistake. How do you solve this problem? The best way to solve this problem is do not take any risk with the savings account or with the FD account. Directly open a block account, and in that block account, they will be more confident that now this money is reserved for you while you're going to stay in Germany for 1 year, and you cannot utilize this money for any other purposes or remove this or withdraw this money. So the best solution to this is use a block account. Do not take risk with your savings account or your FD. All these things used to work well in job seeker visa, but the scenario with opportunity card is different. They are being super strict in providing this visa, so make sure you do not take any risk. And in case if you want to open a best block account, then I would say Expatrio has a very good package of the block account and the health insurance. Either you can go through Expatrio, or you can open a block account with that any of the local banks, say SBI, HDFC, ICICI, whichever bank provides you that information, you can open a block account with them. But one thing which is very important is whenever you open a block account, always check with them how can you release the money in case your visa gets rejected. So that is super important, and every bank will have their own process. So I hope this clears your doubt. The first reason is not enough proof of funds. The second main reason why your visa can get rejected is that you do not have a proper health and travel insurance for 12 months. Now, as you know, opportunity card is for 12 months, and you have to buy a health insurance as per the German public health insurance standards, and that fulfills all the criteria. The main thing to notice, in case if you're trying to buy an Indian health insurance, say from Tata AIG or any listed companies that is mentioned on the German embassy, the main problem is that they do not provide health insurance for 365 days. The maximum duration that they provide health insurance or travel insurance is for 6 months. But for opportunity card, you need health insurance for 365 days, and that should fulfill all the criteria that is mentioned on their website, that the maximum deductible should only be 300 euros and not more than that. It should cover all previous illnesses and so many other criteria. So the best solution to this rejection is that you try to take Dr. Walter's health insurance. It's going to be definitely expensive than the Indian health insurance, but it is a German health insurance, and that really, really will help you in providing the right document. The best part about Dr. Walter's health insurance is you do not have to pay anything right now. You only have to pay once you travel to Germany, and I think the approximate value for that is between 35 to 37 euros per month. So that is what you would need to pay for 12 months. So I think the best way is take Dr. Walter's health insurance. Again, how can you buy this? You can just go to Expatrio, and just even if you do not want a block account from them, I think you can still take the health insurance from them or directly try to call Dr. Walters. So this is the best solution to the second problem of health and travel insurance. Now, the third main reason why your opportunity card visa can get rejected is because your intent to travel to Germany is not clear. Your strategy to find a job is not clear. Basically, your motivation letter is not created properly. I have created a detailed video on how should you write your motivation letter, but please understand, you can download the template from this particular video, but do not copy paste the content from this video. The content has to be your own content. So the main reason that they have clearly mentioned in the rejection letter is that your motivation of coming to Germany is not very clear, or even how are you going to find the job, that course of action is not very clear. So the solution to this problem is that you need to make sure the motivation letter that you are writing, you are writing your own personal story. You are not copy pasting from ChatGPT. You are not using someone else's template or somebody else's course of action. You are creating your own personal story, your own personal motivation on why do you want to come to Germany. Second, you are drafting very clearly what is your course of action of finding a job here in Germany. Go ahead, go on LinkedIn, do a research on your job roles and then provide them the inputs that I see more than 500 jobs available for my particular role. I plan to start my job search journey from Berlin or from Frankfurt. I plan to attend a lot of job fairs. Give them data that there is an upcoming job fair in December. I plan to attend that. I'm already talking to people on LinkedIn and I'm already discussing that. So all this is super important. But basically, the motivation letter has to be your personal story, your personal intent of coming to Germany, and your personal course of action on how are you going to find a job here in Germany. The motivation letter is super, super, super important. And another thing I want to tell you, when you get the rejection letter, you do not get rejection for one particular reason. Sometimes you get rejection for multiple reasons combined. So that is why you need to make sure that all these reasons are met and not only one reason you take care of. And the other thing in the motivation letter is that you should also provide some proof of interview calls that you have already attended in Germany. Now, I know most of you will tell me that we are applying but we are not getting any interview calls. Well, if you're not getting any interview calls, that means your resume is not created as per German standards and you are not, you know, applying enough jobs. So in case if you want to learn how do you create a perfect CV as per the German standards, please take this crash course that I have created and that will definitely help you craft a better CV. Or if you want, you can book my slot and I can help you and understand where are you going wrong in your resume creation. But in the current case of opportunity card, you cannot take any risk. It is very clearly mentioned on their website that you need to show some interview proofs that you have already getting interview calls from Germany. And that is super important for your entire application file for opportunity card. So do not take all this lightly. I'm telling you, the visa is only being granted to somebody who has all these tick marks and they are not being lenient or giving any benefit of the doubt. Now, the fourth reason why your visa can get rejected is because your English language or your German language skills are not good enough. Now, very surprisingly, this is a very different rejection reason I have seen this time. So basically, in case if you're writing a motivation letter and you have a lot of grammar errors, you have a lot of spelling mistakes and your English mentioned in your motivation letter is incorrect, they feel you do not have enough English skills. And moreover, even if you fall into the option one category of opportunity card, but still, some embassies are asking you to show proof of German language. That means at least you are learning German or not. And the very first time, they are also taking interviews. Usually, the visa was never an interview process. You used to submit the documents and they used to reply back. But for opportunity card, they are taking interviews. You might even get a call from the embassy for 15 minutes. In case if you say, you know, A2 German language, they will call you for 15 minutes and they will ask you to speak in German for 15 minutes. So they have started taking interview calls. And some embassy like Chennai, Delhi, they are asking you to fill a form, and in that form they are asking you to mention on the day of appointment, they are asking you to mention what is your motivation to come to Germany, what are your German language skills. In case if you mention your German language skills as A1, A2, then maybe the person there itself will start talking to you in German and ask you to introduce yourself in German. So that is what is happening right now. So you have to carry enough proof for the German language and English language skills. And you need to make sure that you do not have any spelling mistakes in your motivation letter. So if you want to apply for opportunity cards, start taking German lessons from today itself. Again, I have tied up with this great institute. They've already trained more than 80,000 candidates and you can take online courses from them and they will help you with the quick fast learning of German language within 1 or 2 months because they have classes daily, because we understand that everybody is in a rush to now learn German language for opportunity card. So you can go ahead and click on the link in the description below in case if you want to register for the German classes. You will get special discounts if you are going through my channel. Now, fifth and the last reason why your visa can get rejected is that you have not booked the accommodation for 12 months. So a lot of people are taking risks that let's book the accommodation for 1 month, 2 months, or even 6 months. And then we can tell that, you know, in the motivation letter that I will do the remaining bookings later. But as I said, right now, they are only providing visa with to the applications who have perfect file and who have followed each and every step that they have mentioned on their website. So the solution to this problem is that you have to book an accommodation for 12 months. Do not take any risk of 1 month, 2 months, or 3 months. It has to be for 12 months. You can book a refundable booking or you can book a hostel or a dormitory from booking.com, but you need a booking confirmation email for 12 months. If you cannot book something entirely for 12 months, then book for 1 month each. But you have to show the booking from the start date of your travel till the end date of your travel, which is for the period of 1 year. So this is another last reason why your visa can get rejected. If I get to know about any more reasons, then definitely I'm going to create a video or a short about it and explain you about it. So please go ahead and follow this channel to keep getting such latest update and tips on your visa. Lastly, I want to tell you that they are providing visa only to the applications or to the files that have everything perfect. So do not take a risk with anything. Make sure you have a perfect motivation letter, perfect health insurance, block account, your German and English language skills are great, and your accommodation is great. In case if you need help in any of this or you want me to review your documents before you go for your visa appointment, definitely you can book my one-to-one slot for the opportunity card visa, and I will go ahead and review your motivation letter, also review your documents and help you with it. In case if you want to get some interview calls while directly you are in your home country, because that is also one of the requirements for opportunity card, you need to have a perfect CV, and I can help you with creating that perfect CV, or you can take my crash course. Definitely the intent of this channel is to provide you a lot of information when it comes to Germany or your next job change. So go ahead and click on like and subscribe, and please share this video with all your friends and family. At the end of all this, remember, you have to stay happy and you have to stay super, super healthy, because that is very important. This is Gurpreet signing off for today, and I will see you again with another detailed video for Germany. So take care. Bye. Have a great day ahead.